Lust der Götter und Menschen. Gespielin, Gespielin der Unmut. Komm zu meinem Gesang von jedem Hügel herunter.
I'm Rupert Charlesworth. I'm a tenor, and we are doing a recording. We're currently in Freiburg. It's about exploring new material and finding music that hasn't been done before, sort of giving it a platform for people to hear. Everybody knows J.S. Bach, and few people know a few bits of C.P. Bach, but he's not so well known.
Ce n'est pas le premier disque que nous consacrons à Carl-Philippe Emmanuel. Cette fois-ci, nous avons voulu réunir des pièces plutôt chambristes. Donc, il s'agit d'un programme assez varié, qui réunit donc des trio-sonates pour deux violons et basse continue, une sonatine qui est quasiment un concerto pour clavecin, et un chanteur qui intervient pour une partie du programme pour des cantates de chambre. On a imaginé un programme de concert varié avec de la musique instrumentale, de la musique vocale, comme ça pouvait se faire sans doute à l'époque. Nous cherchions à explorer une autre facette de ce compositeur, donc Carl-Philippe Emmanuel. Lui, il explore plus la charnière entre la période baroque et la période classique.
He's kind of one of those composers that sort of begins to bridge the gap between what you would think of as typically Baroque era music and typically classical music. At times can sound very like early Baroque, and other times much more classical, a bit more like Haydn, particularly with some of this quartet stuff. Frühling is about sort of God and nature and how the sort of joys of nature and sort of life bursting forth into spring. It's incredibly joyful and variant. There are all these little tunes that come and pop up, and then the singer notices something else, and then there's a tune about that, and notices it, which is exactly what happens in spring. So I think it's very, very apt the way he's sort of coloured this entire piece to represent life kind of bursting forth, really, which is very lovely.